This is the car that solidified Toyota's name in the racing industry. This is also the car that beat the Europeans in the World Rally Championship. Surprisingly, this is the same car that was supposed to be competing against the Mustang. Ladies and gentlemen, the Celica.
Toyota introduced the Celica in 1971 to compete with the big American muscle cars. So if you observe, the older generation Celicas used to look like something that popped out of Detroit. The Celica was significantly cheaper than cars like the Mustang and the Camaro, and thus made it into an instant hit.
So this generation Celica is the sixth generation. This was the biggest game changer in terms of technology across all generations because it had water injection from factory and plumbing for an anti-lag system already set up. The previous generation won the WRC four times and this one continued its streak. But in 1995, they had a little feud and they were accused by the European race division about cheating because this was the first anti-lag system car in WRC.
The FIA had noticed that the WRC cars were getting crazy fast and were approaching Group B specs. They had forced all turbo cars to put a restrictor plate. But Toyota was really cunning and made a system that basically made the air go around the restrictor plate and create the same amount of horsepower. But this meant the end of the Celica's WRC dominance. Which means this is the proper last gen homologated Celica to ever be produced. This is a really special car.
Surprised to see a four-cylinder. So was I. But actually, Celicas only come in four-cylinders. This is a 3S GE engine, which is a 2-liter, four-cylinder, 135 bhp, 196 newton meters of torque, naturally aspirated engine. You can get a 3 GTE engine with the GT4 line. This is a GTS. This is naturally aspirated. That one will have a turbo and is dank, but this one's a GTS. The styling of the Celica drastically changed in this model year. The long swooping bonnet and the round headlights surely made it look such a Euro-spec car. But it is unmistakably a JDM car, thanks to this. Come with me. This big ass wang. Okay, so let me tell you a few cool things that I really like about this car. First of all, you've got Japanese written everywhere, especially this red button down here next to the gear lever, which is red and is the only red button and is written in Japanese. So we don't know what is going on with that button. There's Japanese written up here in the windows and it just makes you feel like it's such a JDM car. Also, you've got frameless windowsills, which make it look so cool, even though it's a 93 car. So how Audi's got the sport back, we've got the lift back. So the Germans actually ripped it off of this. And did I mention my big dinner table as well as this? Okay, it's really slow. How cool is that? It's an automatic antenna for the radio.
All in all, the Celica is a true gem for a car enthusiast and a great canvas for a project. But they're very rare. and they'll cost you around 6 to 10 lakhs if you ever get a hold of one. The Japanese engines of this era are very reliable, and you can do anything to them and they'll still not break a sweat. That's why this is such a great car, because it comes from a time of change, which is what I feel. Huge thank goes to our boys at FNL for letting us film at their garage. What are your thoughts on this baby Supra? Do let us know in the comment section down below. Please like the video and subscribe for more amazing car content. This is Bhavneet signing out.